In this video, we'll discuss about the DevOps principle. So this has been taken from this page, referred from this page. First one is the customer-centric action. Usually we keep talking about this, right? The customer has to be the center of all our activities and focused on that. The reason why DevOps has been successful is because it really makes it practicable. There is a continuous feedback which is coming from the customer. Okay, and we get the feedback implemented. Since it's all smaller cycles, about 2 weeks or somewhere around that, it is easier for us to implement it and get the feedback and continuously incorporate it. So customer centric action is a very important aspect of DevOps, very important principle of DevOps. I'm sure all the philosophies talk about it, whereas here it is more practicable, the reason why it has been more successful. Second one is create with the end in mind. Always create what outcome or result we want and measure that outcome. That's one of the important aspect or important principle of DevOps. When we keep that in mind, then everything else falls in place. In agile methodologies and in DevOps, we do what we call as user stories, right? What the customer wants to see, what feature he wants to see in his own words, and then it gets implemented. And work towards that. All the resources, all the team members start working towards that. Third one is that end-to-end responsibilities. We saw that in waterfall model, you know, since it is all linear, in each of the stages, probably different teams are working on it. Whereas here, there are small teams, you know, what we call as a two-pizza teams, or about 5 to 6 people working together in releasing that feature or product they have to release, and they want the responsibility of it, right? And the team is structured in such a way all the required resources are in that team, so that issues get resolved fast, and if it is not, so the team is accountable for it. And the next one is that cross-functional autonomous team. We discussed about this in detail in the last point itself. It's all cross-functional. There will be a sysadmin, there will be a tools admin, there will be an implementer, and there will be a tester, and so on, right, in that team. And people are also expected to be multi-skilled. You know, there will be a primary skills and also a secondary skill, so that in case if someone is not there, the others can pick up and accomplish it. And next is that automate everything you can. So this is one of the, you know, very big advantage. By principle, we have to automate wherever it is possible, not by choice or not by chance, by design. Okay. And also all the tools, all the software required has to be there. Once the code gets built, you know, it moves to the next stage automatically and so on, right? There is manual intervention is required, you know, where it is absolutely required, for example, approval processes and so on. Otherwise, everything is automated. And as we keep it as a principle, it helps to go ahead and start looking for tools and implement them, and then take the feedback, and it becomes a continuous loop, endless infinite loop, as in the DevOps loop. Okay. Next is continuous improvement. As we continue to work with the customer on a day in and day out basis, since smaller cycles are there, we are able to get the feedback from the customer and implement it immediately. And this is what results in a continuous improvement, right? And incremental improvement is a part of it. From one scrum to the next scrum, there is a small consistent improvement, which definitely results in exponential improvement over a period of time. So these are all the 6 DevOps principle in which the DevOps methodology is built on, and hope you find it useful. Before closing it, we will just do a recap. Customer-centric action. Customer is the left, right, and center of all the activities. You know, everything starts from the customer, and we are here to delight the customer. Second, create with the end in mind. Create with the customer in mind, and also what the customer wants. That's important aspect of DevOps. Third one is end-to-end responsibility. the team owns the responsibility. If something is broken, it is the team is responsible, or one of the members of the team is responsible, so that they are able to support each other in ensuring that they move forward. Cross-functional automation team. Every feature, every detail is available within the team. Every skill set required is available within the team. This is a big differentiator over the waterfall models, where there are distributed teams, siloed teams, which may take some time. Fifth one is automate everything you can. It is obvious. Automate as much as we can so that it continues to move on from one stage to the other. Next one is continuous improvement. Small improvements over a period of time can give exponential outcome or exponential results. That's what it means. Hope you find this useful. Let's move on to the next one. Thank you. Bye.